Now we discuss about the decoder combinational circuit. So a decoder is a combinational logic circuit that receives coded information of n input lines and converts them to maximum of 2 to the power n unique output lines. So decoder is functions just opposite to a encoder, and the decoder outputs will have less than 2 to the power n outputs when some of the n bits decoded informations are unused or are do not care combinations. Now we see the block diagram, truth table and logic circuit of decoder. So now this is a block diagram of n 2 to the power n decoder. Here n numbers of inputs, then it decodes 2 to the power n outputs. If n is 3, that is 3 inputs, then output will be 2 to the power 3 equal to 8. So 8 outputs, it is marked as O0, O1 to O7. So it is a 3 into 8 decoder. Now we see the logic circuit and the truth table. So since there is a 3 inputs, so we have given A, B, C. A, B, C, these are the 3 inputs and outputs are O0, O1, O2, O3, O4, O5, O6 and O7. So for the 3 inputs, what are the combinations? First is 0, 0, 0, then 0, 0, 1. So when all the 3 inputs are 0, then the output O0 is selected. So this is 1 and the rest of the outputs are 0. When the input 001 is selected, O1 output is 1. Others are 0. For the third case, O2 output is selected. For the fourth case, output O3 is selected. For the last combinations, when all the inputs is high, then output I7 is high. So this is the truth table for 3 into 8 decoder. So these are the inputs and these are the outputs. So now we see the logic diagram for 3 into 8 decoder. So now since there are 8 outputs, 8 numbers of n gates will be there, and the 3 inputs A, B, C are the 3 inputs, and it's complemented with the by using the NOT gate. So for the first combinations 0, 0, 0, that means when all the 3 inputs A, B, C are 0, that means this one and this one 0, then output of the first AND gate, that is O0, is high, it is selected. For the second case 0, 0, 1, that means A is 0, A is 0, B is 0, here B is 0, then C is high, so this is the high line. Then for the third case, B is high, A and C is low. So A is low, B is high, and C is low. For the fourth, B and C is high, A is low. So A is low, B is high, and C is high. So this is the C is high. For the next case, when output O4 is high, then the A is high, then the rest B and C is 0. So A is high, so this one is high line, and B and C is low. Then A and C is high, so here A is high, B is low, and C is high. Then for the sixth output, here the combination is A and B is high, so this is high A. Then B, this line is high, and C is low, so this is the C low line. And for the last AND gate, that means for O7 output, all the three inputs are high. So this is A high line, then B is high, and C is high. So this is the logic circuit for 3 into 8 decoder. So 3 means 3 inputs A, B, C, and 8 means 8 decoded outputs, so O0 to O7. So first you draw the truth table by using these combinations 000, 001. So all these 8 combinations are there, and the 8 outputs O0 to O7 are given here. That means the output, only one AND gate output is high at a time, and the rest of the other output of the AND gates is zero. So this is a three logic circuit of 3 into 8 decoder. So the function of decoder is just opposite to the encoder. So a 3 to 8 line decoder circuit can be used in binary to octal conversion, and the decoder is also used in some code conversion, for example BCD to 7 segment decoder. And another use of a decoder is that it can be used to implement any combinational logic circuit. So we have discussed about the 3 to 8 decoder. Next we see the combinational circuit of adder and subtractor. So first, adder means there are two types of adder, one is half adder and the other is full adder. And first let us see a half adder. Half adder is a combinational circuit that performs the addition of two bits. So in this logic circuit, two binary inputs and two binary outputs are required. Now let us see the block diagram of a half adder. So this is a half adder, so two inputs, two outputs. Suppose A and B are the inputs and S and C is the output. So here the output S equal to A B bar plus A bar B, and C is also known as carry. S is known as sum and C is known as carry. So carry is A into B. Now from this sum equations, the truth table will be A B, then S and C. So the truth table of the half adder for the two inputs A, B, that means 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1. So these are adder. So 0 and 0 is added. So when 0 plus 0, we get a 0. 0 plus 1, the output sum is 1. 1 plus 0 is 0. Sorry, 1. And 1 plus 1 is 0, carry 1. So other carries 0. Now the logic circuit of a half adder is for two inputs, that is A and B, then two AND gates, and the output of the two AND gates are added, so there is a one OR gate. This is the S output, and the other is C, carry output. So here the input is A, then A naught, and B, and B naught. So for the first case, when 0, 0, that means A 0 and B 0. For the second, 0, 1. 0 when output is high. So sum is, when sum is high, when the combination is 0, 1. So we have to put 0 and 1. For the next case, the sum is high when the input combination is 1, 0. So this is 1 and this is 0. So output is A B bar plus B, A bar B. And in the next case, the C carry, it is A into B. So A is A high, B high, carry is 1. Here A high and B high. So this is the half adder logic circuit. So what is a half adder logic circuit? Half adder logic circuit is a combinational logic circuit which added 2 bits and it gives 2 outputs. 2 bits means A and B, and S outputs are sum and carry. So sum equations is A B bar plus A bar B, and carry, it is the output is A into B. So in the truth table, for 2 bits, the 4 combinations are there. And the output sum is high when any of the input is high. And when both the inputs are equal, that means either it is 0 or it is 1, then the sum output is 0. And for the carry output, when both the inputs are 1, then the output is high. So this is the logic circuit for half adder. Next, we will see a full adder combinational circuit. So now we will discuss about the full adder combinational circuit. A full adder combinational circuit is a circuit which added 3 bits binary signals or binary inputs, and there are 2 outputs, sum and carry. It consists, the 3 input consist A and B, which we have already seen in case of half adder, and the third input is the carry, which is coming from the lower order bits when multi-bit addition is performed. So in case of a full adder, 2 of the input variables, suppose A and B, represents the 2 significant bits to be added, and the third variable, that is C, which is represent to carry from the previous lower significant position, and the output variables, that is S, which gives the value of the least significant bit of the sum, and the output variable C, which gives the output carry. Now let us see the truth table and the logic circuit of a full adder. So Here, full adder, this is a block diagram, three inputs A, B and C, and two outputs S and C, sum and carry. The outputs sum, it is represented as the relation by this, that means A bar B bar C plus A bar B C bar plus A B bar C bar plus A B C. And the equation of the carry, that is C, is AB plus BC plus CA. And here the truth table has three inputs ABC and the combinations, it is written like this. And for the sum, when A 0 0, that means 0 plus 0 is 0, again 0 plus 0 it is 0. Then for the next, 0 plus 0 is 0, and 0 plus 1 it is 1. Then 0 plus 1, 1, 1 plus 0, it is 1. Then 0 plus 1, it is 1, and 1 plus 1 is 0, carry 1. So here, the carry is 0. And for the fifth combination, 1 plus 0 is 1, and 1 plus 0 is 1. And 1 plus 0 is 1, 1 plus 1 is 0, carry 1. Then 1 plus 1 is 0, carry 1. 0 plus 0 is 0. Then 1 plus 1 is 0, carry 1. 0 plus 1 is 1. So this is the outputs of the full adder. What we have seen here, that when any of the input is high, that is 1, the output sum is high. And when any of the two inputs are equal, that means here 1, 1, the output is low. Now we draw the logic circuits. Here for the first is sum S. First we have given 4 AND gates. Then because 4 terms is there, and 1 OR gate. So for the first combination 0 0 0, sum is 0. For the next, when sum is high, for the combination 0 0 1, that means A is 0 0 and C is high. For the next case, when 1 is high, A is 0, B is high, C is 0. A is 0, B is high, and C is 0. For the next, this combination, A is 1, B and C is 0. A is 1, and B and C is 0. Then, for the last combinations, all A, B, C are 1. So here, this is A high, B high and C high. So this is the logic diagram for the S output. And for the C output, that is carry, when it is 1, when the combination is, so this A B plus B C plus C A, these are the A B C. So first case, when it is high, that is B C, so B B, C. Next it is high, that means A, C. So A, C. Then it is high, A, C, then B, C, A, B. So A, B. So this is the circuit for the output carry C, and this is the circuit for the output sum. So now, dear learners, in today's class, what we have discussed till now, first we have discussed the combinational logic circuit. What is a combinational logic circuit? It is a circuit which consists of some interconnected set of logic gates with some input variables and output variables. and the some examples of combinational circuits we have discussed. First, we have discussed a multiplexer. So a multiplexer is a combinational circuit where the binary information is selected from one of the 2n input lines and it is transmitted to a single output line. So if the n is a number of selection lines, then that 2n combinations will be there. So multiplexer is also called many to one. Next, we have discussed the demultiplexer. So demultiplexer, in the multiplexer we have discussed the 1-to-4 demultiplexer. So it is a 1-to-many. And after that we have gone through a encoder, which is a combinational circuit which generates the binary code for the 2n input variables. That means 2n into n encoder. Next, we have seen a decoder combinational circuit which receives codes information on n input lines and transmit them to maximum of 2n unique output lines after conversion. And next, we have discussed the adder. So there are two adders, one is half adder and a full adder. In the half adder, it is a combinational circuit that adds 2 bits, and next is the full adder which is used to add 3 bits. So in the next class, we will discuss about the subtractor, and then we go to our next unit, that is sequential logic circuit. So in sequential logic circuit, the output is depends on the input as well as the past outputs. So in sequential circuit, a memory is used. So that's all for today's class. In the next class, we will continue the next part. And thank you, learners.